There is one sort of labor which adds to the value of the subject upon which it is bestowed. There is another which has no such effect. Smith distinguishes between two kinds of labor, productive labor and unproductive labor. A manufacturer generally adds value to whatever he or she is working on, hopefully. If you employ a bunch of manufacturers in your factory, the revenue you can generate by selling the manufactured goods will more than make up for their wages. The
labor
of the servant, on the other hand, doesn't add value to anything. If you employ a bunch of those, you won't see that money again. Don't let Smith's confusing wording throw you off here. Unproductive in this case doesn't mean it's not valuable. It just means that it doesn't add value to a thing which can then be sold for more than it was originally worth. Both of these labors have, of course, value in a broader sense and deserve reward. By this definition, though, the army, police, and dare I say, even politicians fall under the category of unproductive labor. Their service, however useful and necessary, produces nothing which could afterwards purchase an equal amount of labor. That's why you don't invest in the police thinking that they're gonna make you money by producing something. Everyone knows that you invest in the police because you want them to be nice to you in case you ever do something stupid later in life. Back to Smith. The tune of the musician, the dramatic expression of the actor, all of that perishes at the very instant it is produced. At least that was the case back when Smith was around. The more such services are consumed, the less income and capital will be left for future investments, which lowers next year's national product. Both productive and unproductive laborers, as well as people who don't work at all, are maintained by the annual produce of a country. The whole annual produce is the product of productive labor, except for that stuff that just randomly grows on the ground. This produce, once it has turned into revenue, divides itself into two parts. The first to replace lost capital, which is just repairing and maintaining machines, stocking up on provisions and the wages for the laborers. Gotta maintain those as well. The second is the profit of the person who owns the capital or the rent of the person who owns the land. So now we know that spending on unproductive labor is wasting capital. But don't worry, that's not the only way to waste capital. We can also just invest it very poorly. Every failed project in trade or mining or anything else for that matter is a loss in the productive funds of a country. According to Smith, however, private individuals tend to be very careful about investing their capital. That makes sense because if it goes wrong, it might ruin them financially. Therefore, nations usually aren't ruined by private individuals. The problem really lies with the government, which spends most of its capital on unproductive labor. Courts, firefighters, teachers, policemen, and the army. While these may be very reasonable things to spend money on, they still count as unproductive labor. Smith still thinks, however, that governments tend to overspend. Great nations are never impoverished by private, though they sometimes are by public prodigality and misconduct.
Prodigality.
Using some big words there, Smith. According to Smith, people are very good at getting better at their jobs and increasing productivity. They're also very good at saving and investing in productive labor, since it'll make them better off in the long run. This is what drives the growth of our national product. The numbers of productive workers going up and their productivity increasing. Through things like better equipment, better organizations and machines, Smith strongly believed that the relationship between the annual capital of society and the annual revenue of society is of vital importance. Capital is invested in productive labor. The bigger its share, the more industry a country will have. Wherever revenue predominates, idleness prevails. So the more capital, the more industry, and the more industry, the more number of productive hands. The more number of productive hands, the higher the exchangeable value of the annual produce of a country, which makes the country wealthier. This chapter in one sentence. Investing capital in productive labor increases it, investing it in unproductive labor diminishes it.